អង្គុយចុះអង្គជំនួយជម្រះប្រកាសបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីសម្នាការនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្នាការដែលអង្គជំនះបានគ្រោងទុកនៅក្នុងដំណើរការសម្នាការសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះគឺការស្ដាប់លិខិតកម្មសាក់សីឈ្មោះសូតទឿងប៉ុន្តែដោយសារបញ្ហាបច្ចេកទេសនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការគឺអង្គជំរះសម្រាប់មិនទាន់ស្ដាប់បន្តការស្ដាប់សក្តិកម្មរបស់សាក់សីរូបនេះទេកិច្ចដំណើរការស្ដាប់សក្តិកម្មសាក់សីឈ្មោះសូតទឿងនេះនឹងលើកទៅបន្តធ្វើនៅរសៀលនេះហើយមុននឹងបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដែងការពិភាក្សាដេញដោលអង្គជំរះសូមប្រកាសផ្ទាល់មាត់នៅដើម្បីសម្រាប់ពាក់ព័ន្ធនៅសិទ្ធិនៅស្គៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបរបស់ជនចាប់ចោតអង្គជំរះគាត់ធំគល់នៅសំណើសុំពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសិទ្ធិនៅស្ងៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតអៀងសេរីនិងខៀវសំផនឯកសារ E164 និង E174អង្គជំនុំជំរះគាត់ធំគល់បន្ថែមថាក្រោយពីបានធ្វើសេចក្តីថ្លែងការណ៍ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងវគ្គទី1នៃការជំនុំជំរះជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាបានបញ្ជាក់ថាគាត់អាចរសាសិទ្ធនៅស្ងៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបអនុលោមតាមមាត្រា35ថ្មីចំណុចឆនៃច្បាប់ស្តីពីការបង្កើតអង្គជំនុំជម្រះវិសាមញ្ញក្នុងតុលាការកម្ពុជាជន់ជាប់ចោតមិនត្រូវបានបង្ខំឲ្យផ្ដល់សក្តិកម្មប្រឆាំងនឹងខ្លួនឯងឬសារភាពអំពីពិរុទ្ធភាពឡើយហេតុដូច្នេះជនជាប់ចោតមិនអាចត្រូវបានបង្ខំឲ្យឆ្លើយសំណួរដែលត្រូវបានសួរចំពោះគាត់ឡើយទោះជាយ៉ាងណាក៏ដោយនៅក្នុងការវាយតម្លៃអំពីពិរុទ្ធភាពឬភាពសុចរិតរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនៅក្នុងសាក្រមរបស់ខ្លួនអង្គជំរះនឹងពិចារណានៅរាល់ភស្តុតាងដែលបានដាក់ចំពោះមុខខ្លួននិងជាកម្មវត្ថុនៃការពិនិត្យរួមទាំងសក្តិកម្មរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនិងរបៀបដែលជនជាប់ចោតផ្ដល់សក្តិកម្មក្នុងន័យនេះនឹងនៅពេលដែលជនជាប់ចោតសម្រេចជ្រើសរើសដោយខ្លួនឯងរវាងសិទ្ធិនៅស្ងៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបនិងការផ្ដល់សក្តិកម្មនោះអង្គជំនុំជម្រះអាចនឹងកត់ធំគល់អំពីបញ្ហានេះនៅពេលវាយតម្លៃអំពីភាពគួរឲ្យជឿជាក់បានរបស់គាត់យុទ្ធសាស្ត្រអន្តរជាតិដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធបង្ហាញថាការសម្រេចជ្រើសរើសដោយខ្លួនឯងក្នុងការនៅស្ងៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបអាចត្រូវបានប្រើក្នុងការទាញចេញជាសេចក្តីសន្និដ្ឋានផ្ទុយនៅក្នុងករណីណាក៏ដោយអង្គជំនុំជម្រះនឹងមិនផ្អែកទាំងស្រុងលើការទាញជាសេចក្តីសន្និដ្ឋានផ្ទុយចេញពីការរក្សាសិទ្ធិនៅស្ងៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបនៅក្នុងការវិនិច្ឆ័យអំពីកំហុសឡើយបើនេះជាស្ដីសម្រេចពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងការរសារសិទ្ធិនៅស្គៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតហើយជាកិច្ចបន្តអង្គជំរះសម្រេចធ្វើសម្ណការជាអសាធារណៈដោយមិនពិភាក្សាដេញដោលលើសាក់សីទៅលើអង្គហេតុដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងការផ្ដោតទៅខីកម្មនោះឡើយដោយសារបញ្ហាបច្ចេកទេសនៃការពិភាក្សាផ្ទៃក្នុងភាគីជាមួយនឹងអង្គជំរះដើម្បីរកដំណោះស្រាយជាមូលដ្ឋានក្នុងការអនុវត្តនៅវិធាន28ចំណុច89គឺសិទ្ធិមិនធ្វើតខីកម្មប្រឆាំងខ្លួនឯងដែលបញ្ហានេះវាមានការជំរងចម្រាស់ខ្លាំងកាលពីព្រឹកមិញដើម្បីដោះស្រាយបញ្ហារួមក្នុងការបន្តធ្វើសក្តិកម្មស្ដាប់សក្តិកម្មទៅមុខទៀតឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់ចេះតឡាស់នោះអង្គជំរះសម្រេចបើកសម្ណការជាសាធារណៈអសាធារណៈ đại biểu phía sau tây khánh đồng biên phía ký cho mùi nâng ong nhầm rẻ lừa bánh hà ni sản phẩm đầm nà ca sản nà ca ni lâu đọc biên ngày trăng được cho nên sa thông tha thiên đại chuyển chiêm hay bọc bọc một tay đoạt ba là cá rụt bật vàng nón hay nâng bọc bòn sau tua đại sầm lên rụp hiệp trên từ sa thiên nạn ហើយថាទីណាជនអាចសម្រាបានហើយរហូតដល់ក្រោយពេលហៅថ្ងៃត្រង់ទើបអាចអង្គជំរះនឹងពិនិត្យពិចារណាសម្រាប់ថាតើធ្វើសម្ដនាការតាមបែបណាអាចជាថ្មីបន្ទាប់ពីការតិចវិភាសាឬបញ្ហាបច្ចេកទេសក្នុងការសួរដេញដោលសាក់សីរូបនេះ sản xuất chơi sao thế lại chuyên tranh cai nữa tranh cai vừa tụt sạm na cá mà đời xa miền bảy hà bị chạy cái tê đầu viên nẹp bộ prai chỉ mới nâng sao sạ mạn ca chia sòng ngặt đi person ba tục đầu bang viên nón cứ nẹp bộ prai mình ai mưa khơi hay miền ca lồng bạn được nông ca bộ prai phía xa được cho nên là mày ăn vọt ở ban là o nử lử bộ bài phía xa thì đấy ở lứa đấy nè là luôn bậc này chỉ để lớn trần xa mày lần đi đây xa bánh hạ bạch chạy cái tê này cả bộ bài cả bật tục rộng băng viên nôn khăn rồi viên bật tục sạm nạ ca ni bạn ấy bài lâu đây xa bị chạy cái ti nông cao bộ phái phía xa và sân ba tục rộng băng viên nôn khăn rồi viên nẹ bộ phái phía xa chỉ mùi nâng bộ tục sạm nà ca vì phía xa ní cư miền ca lòng bạ nông ca bộ phái phía xa được cho nên ông nhầm rè xâm ra cho ôi môn trầy rọt ba tà la cá rút băng viên nôn bình ban ប្រសិនបើសាធារណជនបានចាក់ចេញពីសាលសាធារណៈអស់ហើយនោះដើម្បីសម្រួលដល់ការបកប្រែភាសា
Sống chơi, mình cứ khởi mê tư vi ảnh ra chiết cà phía cái đây nôn chía, cà rộng chờ hay miền bầm nông chọn lực làng lực bánh hà bây tớ, sống chơi.
Your Honours, I haven't heard a word.
Look, mê tư vi, khi mình sẽ đáp bàn lục thiên ở phần sông lời thế lục thiên.
Tổng chơi luôn, đồng nàng thập rồi nhá.
Đồng nàng thập rồi nhá. Khiêm xong ảnh nhạt, đồng bày, chúng tôi biết là cả Channel 2 sẽ đạp một bàn thế con tay. Channel 8, phòng lịch đồng bày bàn sẽ đạp bàn. Tôi chứ nế, ảnh nhìn phía kia nâng nạ để sẽ đạp ảnh bắt đầu bọc tự tạm luôn bạn.
Pour le français, peut-être pouvez-vous essayer le canal 9 pour ceux qui ont des problèmes. Est-ce que sur le canal 9, vous entendez ce qui se passe?
Oui.
Est-ce que toutes les parties entendent maintenant dans leur casque les traductions?
បាទស្ដាប់បានហើយស្ដាប់បានទេខាងមេធាវីការពីក្តីនួនជាមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិអមាញ់មិញបន្ទាប់នៅក្នុងឡុងពេលដែលយើងបានចេញដីតម្រាច់តលមាត់មិញឃើញលោកក្រោកឈរតើមានបំណងនិយាយពីបញ្ហាអីទៅសូមជឿន
Thank you, Your Honor. I can hear you now on channel 8, but only just now. So I didn't get anything earlier.
Okay, mình miền đầu lưỡi tiếp bị khang đám khiêm chong còn được chìm riệp từ là cá bị bệnh hại nên sẽ bận nó.
I missed you.
Sống chơi lưu sợi chắc rồi.
Just for your information, Channel 8 always has the English interpretation, but this is the channel apparently for English when the session is closed. Channels 7, 8 and 9, but if you want to tune to Channel 8, you will always hear the English translation.
Thank you. Mr. Thuy, some of you look very
មេធាវីការពីក្តីលោកនួនជាតើមានបញ្ហាអ្វីទេ
Technical issues?
មេធាវី Andy តើលោកធានចង់
You're referring to the substance of
យើងទៅរកបញ្ហាបច្ចេកទេសឬក៏លោកមានសាស្ត្រតទៅនឹងខ្លឹមសារនៃសាវនាការអសាធារណៈបាទ
អមញ្ញមញ្ញនេះគឺអំណងឡងពេលដែលយើងខ្ញុំអាននៅស្ដីសម្រេចទី1រួចពាក់ព័ន្ធជាមួយនឹងសិទ្ធិនៅស្ងៀមមិនឆ្លើយតបរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតខ្ញុំបានសម្រេចបញ្ហាទី2ពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងថាមិនធ្វើសកម្មភាពដេញដោលលើសាក់សីរូបនេះទេអង្គខ្ញុំរះសម្រេចធ្វើសកម្មភាពជាអសាធារណៈដើម្បីដោះស្រាយបញ្ហាដែល មានការចម្រងចម្រាស់គ្នាក្នុងការអនុវត្តនៅវិធានវិធាន28បំបីនិង23ដែលលើកឡើងដោយភាគីដោយសារវាមិនទាន់បានជ្រះសលាស់នៅឡើយទាល់តែដោះស្រាយបញ្ហានឹងឲ្យបានជ្រះសលាស់ហើយដើម្បីធ្វើជាមូលដ្ឋានសម្រាប់ដំណើរការដេញដោលសាក់សីរូបនេះគឺសូត្រទឿងនេះ នឹងសម្រាប់ធ្វើជាមូលដ្ឋាននៅក្នុងការបន្តការស្ដាប់សក្ខីកម្មសាក់សីដតីទៀតនៅពេលក្រោយក្នុងរឿងក្តីនេះដើម្បីឲ្យបានដំណើរការទៅមុខបានរលូនទន្ទឹមនេះយើងបានកលេចឃើញមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិការពារក្តីនួនជាក្រោកឈរ đời xa dương của phong tay thì mẹ nhưng thấy mình toàn ban cửa rụp xích lúc thật ta chơi dê dân mấy bọn nhìn mẹ của phong tay thầm ra nhưng thấy bê đây thầm ra chứ bị hơi nè ông nhầm ra đâm bây cửa rụp xích lúc nó cứ xua bị chạy lần vinh thật ta lúc miên mà tệ cho bà là bây tế đứa có sát đập tại đây thầm mẹ đây dương ban thầm ra nhầm mấy mình ban đâm bây dương ai thầm ra thật cho thầm mấy mà đông tiết đứa có giang mạch đứa có trăm mưa bà tệ chờ đật.
I did get most of it, Your Honor. My colleague was on his feet simply to advise you that Nguyen Chi would be waiving his right to be present for the afternoon session when it was not yet clear that we were going to close session. So that's why Mr. Pao was on his feet. Then after the curtains closed, you made some remarks, Your Honor, Mr. President. I didn't get any of those, so I don't know what you said there. I heard what you just repeated. I heard that the first time. Then you closed the curtains and you said something else. I didn't get any of that. That's when I was on Channel 2. So I don't know what you said. Did you ask me to stand up and make submissions?
But Luke Thien and
Yad,
I sit down?
បំបីនិងភ័យ8 ពំបួនដែលមានការជំរងចម្រាស់គ្នាអ្វីមិននេះដើម្បីរកដំណោះស្រាយបញ្ចប់លុបញ្ហានេះមួយដើម្បីជាមូលដ្ឋានក្នុងការអនុវត្តសម្រាប់ស្ដាប់ទៅខែកម្មសាក់សីនេះបន្តនៅរសៀននេះនិងសាក់សីផ្សេងៗទៀតទៅថ្ងៃអនាគតខាងមុខសូមជើញលោកចក្រមសងម៉ាក់
Oui, merci Monsieur le Président. Effectivement, avant de redonner la parole au parti, la Chambre tient à apporter un certain nombre d'éclaircissements. Nous avons profité de la suspension pour contacter l'unité de soutien aux experts et témoins qui nous a indiqué que le témoin que vous avez entendu ce matin a été contacté, qu'une personne de ce service l'a rencontré le 20 décembre, l'a informé des problèmes qui peuvent se poser en ce qui concerne le droit de ne pas s'auto-incriminer et que le témoin a indiqué qu'il ne souhaitait pas l'assistance d'un avocat. Ceci étant, la Chambre aussi rappelle la pratique qu'elle avait mise en place dans le cadre du procès 001, pratique qui consistait à la mise en place d'une équipe d'avocats qui sont à la disposition des témoins comparaissent devant la Chambre lorsque des problèmes d'auto-incrimination sont susceptibles de se poser. La Chambre rappelle que cette équipe d'avocats est constituée d'avocats qui ont reçu une formation à laquelle la défense ainsi que les procureurs ont participé. En tous les cas, lorsque ceci a été mis en place dans le cadre du procès 001. La Chambre également souhaite faire part de son étonnement quant aux demandes qui ont été présentées ce matin par l'équipe de Nguyen Chi. Étonnement parce que nous souhaitons quand même rappeler la règle 28.8 en substance et rappeler que cette règle prévoit que si une partie se rend compte que la déposition d'un témoin risque d'incriminer son auteur, il doit informer la Chambre, effectivement c'est ce qui a été fait, mais la règle précise bien, si possible, à l'avance. Si possible, à l'avance. La Chambre, sauf erreur, de ma part,
qu'on
note que les parties sont informées des témoins qui doivent être entendus dans le cadre de ce segment du procès depuis plusieurs mois. Alors, à mon avis, il y a deux questions qui se posent. Soit c'est une question de manque de préparation qui fait que l'équipe de Nimcha s'est rendue compte simplement à l'audience que ce type de problème pouvait se poser. Soit il s'agit de la part de l'équipe de Nimcha d'une manœuvre délibérée et nous notons que ce type de comportement peut avoir pour effet d'impressionner le témoin qui doit être entendu. Alors, à moins que l'équipe Nimcha ait d'autres explications à nous donner, mais ni rassurant de se dire qu'il y a peut-être un problème de manque de préparation, et encore moins rassurant de se dire qu'il y a peut-être une volonté d'impressionner un témoin. Alors, souhaiterions en tous les cas que pour l'avenir, si ce genre de problème devait se poser à nouveau, que ceci soit fait longtemps et si possible à l'avance. Je crois que les choses doivent être dites tout à fait clairement. Voilà, je ne sais pas, M. le Président, ou si certains de mes collègues veulent ajouter quelque chose à ce qui a été dit. Je pense, en tout état de cause, que en ce qui concerne le témoin qui devait être entendu ce matin, il sera entendu cet après-midi, et nous ferons tous nos efforts pour que le cas échéant puisse bénéficier de l'assistance d'un avocat si le souhait.
Le président, Madame le juge Sylvia Carpareil.
Thank you, President. I have only one matter to add to what Judge Levin.
Entendu le français sur le canal Khmer, l'anglais est sorti sur le canal français. Madame le juge, vous avez la parole.
Thank you, President.
Merci.
Is the translation?
No, président. No translation. Est-ce que vous entendez maintenant correctement la traduction qu'il faut sur le canal Idoine?
សូមអធិស្ឋានពីអ្នកបកប្រែអ្នកបកប្រែអបិសាខ្មែរចុចប៊ូតុងវាអត់ជាប់លោកប្រធានដល់អញ្ចឹងទៅបកទៅហើយអត់បានដឹងទៅលើតាមការពិតសេវាបកប្រែបានផ្ដល់តែដោយសារប៊ូតុងអត់ជាប់ឥឡូវនេះប៊ូតុងចេញពណ៌ក្រហមហើយសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាន
Try again. Is there interpretation now, President?
Thank you.
Yes, I have just one matter to add to what Judge Levin said. With your permission, President, it is not foreseen by the Chamber that in future such an application be made in open court and in the presence of the witness, that is, an application that the Chamber reminds a witness of his rights concerning self-incrimination. And I emphasize that any such applications should be made in advance. But if by reason of something unusual occurring or lack of preparation, a party becomes aware only when that witness is giving evidence, the proper approach to take is to seek an in-camera hearing pursuant to Rule 28.8 without any further comments being made, which could leave the chamber to infer lack of preparation or a deliberate attempt to influence a witness. So there is no need for a lot of detail to be indicated. It is sufficient to make an application pursuant to Rule 28.8 for an in-camera hearing. Thank you, President.
May I respond, Your Honor? Thank you. I'd just like to make it very clear that it's not a lack of preparation. It's not a deliberate ploy. The issue arose this morning when the witness made it very clear that his right, that he was unclear of the full extent of his right. That's when the issue arose. The witness said this morning, in response to the preliminary questions by the President, that he was not completely clear. Our position is that the warning, the Rule 28 caution, needs to be much more comprehensive. I made that request immediately pursuant to Rule 28.8, quote, in advance of the testimony of the witness. That's what Rule 28.8 says. The President went through the preliminaries. As the prosecutor rose to his feet and asked his first question at the beginning of the testimony, I rose to my feet and made the remark. So I think I was well within the terms of Rule 28.8. I made the application in advance of the testimony of the witness. As I said earlier today, I didn't reveal anything about the substance of the witness's testimony, which that in-camera aspect of this rule is designed to protect. I didn't suggest that the witness had done anything. I didn't read from his testimony. I didn't give anyone the impression that the witness had specifically done anything. I raised the issue that there may be an issue with respect to self-incrimination. And everybody has that obligation. Everybody in this courtroom has that obligation, not just us. Not just us. And I should note that the international co-prosecutor's comments with respect to Deutsch's potential liability with respect to M13 arose well after this briefing with Weisu. So I would suggest that that is something clearly that the witness could not have been apprised of, that the prosecution's firm position that future prosecutions are always a possibility. That needs to be put to the witness. The witness needs to understand that. He was not apprised of that at this Weisu briefing, I'm sure, because that was nobody's position at the time. So that would be all I have to say about that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. A couple of points. First, I do think it's important for the trial chamber to make very clear that these types of applications and issues need to be done in advance and outside the presence of the witness. I think it's highly dubious to interpret the words in advance of the testimony of the witness to allow you to do it as a witness is about to answer a question. Clearly, this is a matter that needs to be done in advance and outside the presence of the witness, because to raise these issues in front of a witness raises a risk that I think we are now well facing with the current witness, that they will be intimidated, there will be a chilling effect, and that they will be concerned to testify. And it was not just at the outset of the question where this tactic was engaged in. Literally, when the question was put to the witness, were you the bodyguard of Nguyen Chea, the same issue was raised. There is no possible way in which an answer to that question would incriminate the witness. It is very clear that the incrimination that counsel were worried about were of their own client. Now, there will be, as a general matter, there will be witnesses in these proceedings who have given testimony and will be called upon to give testimony in which they will acknowledge participation in crimes. And in those situations, we do have to prepare and understand and have a clear procedure. This witness, however, has given no testimony that implicates himself in the commission of crimes. And that is why we were very troubled by what happened in court this morning. In addition, I think we have an issue now with this particular witness. I'm not sure whether everyone is familiar with the entire history of this witness, so let me just briefly summarize. This witness was interviewed initially back in 2007. At which time he denied that he was the bodyguard of Nguyen Chea. 2 years later, he was brought to the ECC offices and participated in a confrontation with Doik, in which Doik identified him as a messenger of Nguyen Chea who came and received confessions from him. During the confrontation, the witness continued to deny his role. However, the next day, he came back and gave a detailed statement for 2 days in which he acknowledged that he was Nguyen Chea's bodyguard and gave lengthy evidence regarding the activities. Now, these activities related to Nguyen Chea's role in going to the provinces, meeting with leaders there, and the issue of confessions or documents being delivered between Doik and Nguyen Chea. But there was no testimony, certainly, that incriminated the witness. But now, we have a witness who once again seems to be concerned and is retreating in his testimony. There's no way for us to know for sure whether it was due to the conduct of counsel, but we do have a problem here. So it is very important that we avoid any possibility of this in the future. With regard to this witness, obviously we can confront him with his statements. I would submit perhaps we will be able to deal with the problem that way. Perhaps we may need to make a submission to this court that a confrontation with Doik needs to happen again in court, where Doik is asked in open court to again identify whether this person was the messenger and bodyguard of Nguyen Chea. However, before we get to that, we will endeavor to pursue through examination of the witness, reference to his prior statements, and we will try that first. But I do think there is a problem going on with this witness. While his testimony does not incriminate him in any crimes from the period of Democratic Kampuchea, I wasn't sure whether he's being appointed a lawyer, but if for no other reason, because of his testimony having changed once, and now the testimony he's giving in court, he may well be served to have a lawyer to advise him on those issues, if nothing else. It was not clear to me 100% as to whether the court had indicated that he was being provided a lawyer, but I think that would be appropriate at this time. But our concerns are, one, that this not happen with future witnesses, and two, just that the court understand that because of what has happened here, we're going to have to make some effort to confront this witness with his prior statements. Those are my comments on the matter.
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានសូមគោរពលោកប្រធានលោកស្រីចៅក្រមនិងសាវនាការទាំងមូល
away the ban look now your look made to be the man our cap here I look to noon cheer that looked her mean cap with rum tass I say look me comment ban you'll be set about quant that's rob them me tram pain by navy team take no line that just said mean money yay towards a cake camp by channel clue and I need ក្លែងនេះប្រហែលជាមានការយល់ច្រឡំដោយសារថាតាមកពិតសិទ្ធនេះមិនត្រូវមិនមែនតែមួយលើកនេះទេដែលត្រូវបានជំរាបទៅសាកសួររុកនេះដើម្បីឲ្យដឹងពីសិទ្ធរបស់គាត់នៅក្នុងការមិនឆ្លើយដើម្បីធ្វើសកម្មភាពរបស់មន្ត្រីស៊ើបអង្កេតរបស់ ការយឡៃសហចៅក្រុមស៊ើបអង្កេតជាពិសេសនៅក្នុងឯកសារE3/123ហើយនិងឯកសារD234/23នៅក្នុងឯកសារទាំងពីរនេះគឺមានបានគូបញ្ជាក់ច្បាស់ហើយអំពីការដែលថាមន្ត្រីរបស់សហចៅក្រុមស៊ើបអង្កេតដែលជាអ្នកស៊ើបអង្កេតនេះបានជំរាបអំពីសិទ្ធមិនធ្វើសកម្មភាពប្រឆាំងនឹងខ្លួនឯងស្របទៅតាមវិធាន23នៃ វិធានផ្សេងក្នុងដូច្នេះវាមានភាពច្បាស់លាស់ណាស់ថាសាក់សៃរុកនេះបានយល់អំពីសិទ្ធរបស់គាត់ហើយម្យ៉ាងទៀតដូចលោកចៅក្រមប្រធានបានលើកអំបញ្ញមិញគឺថាតាមរយៈសុំទោសលោកចៅក្រមឡាវែងបានលើកអំបញ្ញមិញគឺតាមរយៈអង្គភាពគាំពារសាក់សៃគឺបាននិយាយហើយថាសាក់សៃនេះមិនត្រូវការមានមេធាវីរបស់ខ្លួនទេដូច្នេះពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបញ្ហាសិទ្ធរបស់គាត់គឺគាត់បានយល់ ច្បាស់ក៏ប៉ុន្តែគាត់ថាប្រហែលជានៅពេលដែលលោកចៅក្រមប្រធានបានលើកអំពីសិទ្ធរបស់គាត់ដែលជាសិទ្ធដដែលនេះដោយនិយាយញ័រពេកហើយគាត់មិនបានក្តាប់បានលឿនភ្លាមៗហើយដែលគាត់បាននិយាយថាមិនសូវច្បាស់ដែលជាចំណុចនេះហើយនាំឲ្យលោកមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិការពារលោកដួនជាលើកជាបញ្ហានេះឡើង ហើយការលើកជាបញ្ហានេះទៀតជាការលើកដដែលម្ដងហើយម្ដងទៀតបន្ទាប់ទោះជាមានការសម្រេចអំពីលោកចៅក្រមប្រធានហើយក៏ដោយអំពីបញ្ហានេះដែលខាងដើមម្ដងរត់វិញនេះយល់ថាវាជាបញ្ហាមួយដែលជាបញ្ហាលើសពីអ្វីដែលជាការធម្មតាដែលជាករណីធ្វើឲ្យប៉ះពាល់ទៅដល់ភាពជឿជាក់របស់ ខ្លួននៅក្នុងការឆ្លើយអំពីការពិតនៃចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនុំជម្រះនេះដូច្នេះករណីនេះជាករណីមួយដែលមិនសមហេតុផលហើយប្រសិនបើលោកមេធាវីការពារលោកនួនជាចង់លើកពីបញ្ហានេះគួរតែលោកមេធាវីលើកអំពីបញ្ហានេះដោយសុំឲ្យមានសាវនាការជាសម្ងាត់នៅពេលដែលគ្មានវត្តមានរបស់សាក់សីរុកនេះ នៅពេលដែលសាក់សីរុកនេះមានវត្តមានហើយលោកបានលើកអំពីបញ្ហានេះវាប៉ះពាល់ដល់អារម្មណ៍ជាខ្លាំងទៅដល់សាក់សីរុកនេះហើយដែលក្នុងការឆ្លើយរបស់គាត់ពេលដំបូងពេលឆ្លើយទៅនឹងសំណួររបស់លោកតំណាងសហប្រជាជាតិមានឃើញថាមានចម្លើយរបស់គាត់បានផ្ទុយគ្នាហើយបញ្ជាក់អំពីភាពរីករាយរបស់គាត់នៅក្នុងការឆ្លើយ ទៅនឹងសំណួររបស់សហតំណាងសហប្រជាជាតិរួចទៅហើយដូច្នេះយើងខ្ញុំយល់ថានេះជាបញ្ហាមួយមិនសូវសមស្របទេហើយក៏មានការគ្រប់គ្រងផងដែរទៅដល់អ្វីដែលលោកតំណាងសហប្រជាជាតិបានលើកឡើងថាប្រសិនបើចាំបាច់គួរតែមានការតទល់បន្ថែមទៀតជាមួយនឹងលោកសាក់សីកាំងហ្គេតអ៊ីវហៅដូចសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាន
Thank you, Mr. President. I won't be long. First of all, I believe there was a ruling from the bench that was very clear and quite eloquent as far as how to proceed henceforth with these situations. So I don't think we need to belabor the point, as was just done. That's number one. Number two, it's my understanding that the witness had indicated that he didn't understand today as he was being advised. Hence the reaction from the defense. So I don't, from my perspective, I don't see any ill attempt by the Nunchia team to do anything improper. I do wish to take the opportunity, however, to raise an issue related to this. Last week in DOIC, I reacted several times to the prosecution doing the same thing that they're complaining today. They use the word chilling effect. Last week we had a very clever witness who spent years and years with lawyers, but you cannot compare that witness with this particular witness. And yet Bill Smith was standing up and giving long speeches, telegraphing to the witness, and the witness was therefore thereafter reacting. And that's why I think that there needs to be a mechanism in place where if we're going to be making sensitive arguments that may influence the testimony or the behavior of the witness, the better practice would be to simply ask the court to deal with the matter outside the presence of the witness. Just like this very sensitive issue. I agree with the prosecution. It does have a chilling effect, and it could influence a particular witness, how he or she will behave on the stand, which is why we need to do that. But we need to do this with other matters as well. And that's why I objected last week strenuously when there were matters being talked about in front of DOIC, which obviously gave a very clever witness an opportunity to react. Thank you.
If I may reply very briefly, I think what's perhaps getting lost in this discussion is the crux of the matter, the thrust of Rule 28. It's to protect the witness. It's to protect the witness. And the witness needs to be informed in a way that makes any waiver that he may give an informed waiver, a knowing waiver, a willing waiver, one that's backed by a firm understanding of what it is he's waiving, the consequences of that waiver, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And that's very obvious, I think, from the terms of Rule 28. So just want to make it clear in response to what the prosecution said, this was in no way an attempt to protect Nguyen Chia. This was an attempt to protect the witness, to make sure that the witness is aware, fully aware, in a comprehensible manner of his rights. I'm getting rolling eyes from the bench there, but that's what I'm talking about. That's what Rule 28 says. And it's the prosecution's duty to do this. It's the bench's duty to do this. So that's all I'll say about that. I would make a reference was made by the lawyers for the civil parties to previous warnings that were given to the witness. And now, if you look at those previous warnings, and I'll just quote from one of them, the co-prosecutors wish to impress upon him that they have absolutely no intention of prosecuting him for anything he may have done during the Khmer Rouge era. OCIJ, you will not be prosecuted for events that occurred in Democratic Kampuchea. This is the OCP, the OCIJ, as I've said earlier, of the ECCC. Our position, the prosecution's position, is that there's no telling what the royal government of Cambodia will do. That's the point that I'm trying to make. That's the important point. If, according to the prosecution, DOIC may be prosecuted at some future time for events at M13, clearly not by this tribunal, must be by somebody else in this country, the royal government, then the royal government could very likely, it's a possibility, as the prosecution has said, it's a possibility that they may prosecute people. And I should say that the prosecution's suggestion that this witness, that actually no real concerns of liability arise here. Well, there's all kinds of modes of liability, and the jurisdictional requirements that apply to this court do not necessarily apply to any future national prosecutions. Aiding and abetting is a very well-established mode of liability, so I think it's unfair to say that this witness, it's possible that he would incur liability. It's clear that there's an issue of self-incrimination here, and I think it needs to be dealt with in an informed way, and I've spoken too long. Thank you very much. Thank you, Your Honor. Just one brief matter before we adjourn for lunch. Will the witness, will our request that the witness be given a new briefing on this issue, will that, has that been granted? Will we have a ruling on that? Given what he said this morning, given the fact that he's unclear, will he be given a new, will he be given a new briefing by Waisu pursuant to the terms that we've suggested before he resumes his testimony today? And could we please have a ruling on that before he resumes his testimony today? Thank you.
បញ្ហានេះដូចជាអង្គជំនះបានធ្វើការសម្របសម្រួលជាមួយនឹងអង្គភាពគាំពារសាក់សីនិងអ្នកជំនាញរួចហើយដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់ពិនិត្យលទ្ធភាពរំលឹកឲ្យគាត់ឡើងវិញយល់ដឹងអំពីបញ្ហាអ្វីដែលអង្គភាពនេះបាន
បានប្រាប់គាត់នៅក្នុងអំឡុងពេលដែលកំណត់កាលបរិច្ឆេទសម្រាប់ធ្វើសក្ខីកម្មដូចជាលោកសងម៉ាក់បានជម្រាបអញ្ចឹងហើយនៅរុស្ស៊ីនេះដោយសារមូលហេតុនៃការចំណើរការរបស់យើងនឹងមានបញ្ហាដំណងធ្វើឲ្យមានការព្រួយបារម្ភចំពោះសាក់សីក្នុងការផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មអង្គជំរះបានតំណតំរួលជាមួយនឹងខាងអង្គភាពគាំពារសាក់សីនឹងអ្នកជំនាញថានឹងឲ្យផ្ដល់នៅមេធាវីអម
Thank you for that clarification, Your Honor.
Oui, Maître Nianouzi, il y a une chose qui est absolument certaine, c'est qu'il ne revient pas aux avocats de la défense de prévenir les témoins de leurs droits. Vous avez déjà suffisamment à vous occuper, à assurer la défense de votre client. Les avertissements qui doivent être donnés aux témoins le seront par le président et par l'unité de soutien aux témoins et aux experts. J'espère que ceci est suffisamment clair. Chacun doit avoir son rôle. Votre rôle, la procédure, n'est pas de donner des conseils aux témoins. Par ailleurs, je précise aussi que, en ce qui concerne le témoin qui doit être entendu aujourd'hui, un avocat a été contacté. Il doit rencontrer ce témoin qui décidera si oui ou non il entend être assisté d'un avocat ou s'il renonce à ce
droit.
Thank you, Judge Levin. That one point is not clear to me. Rule 28.8 refers to the duty of a party, any party, where a party is aware, etc., etc. Are you saying that we need to disregard the terms of that rule, that we don't have that duty, that we shall not request an interim hearing, we shall request?
Maître Yanouzi, est-ce que vous avez entendu, comme tout le monde ce matin, Yanouzi, le président avertir le témoin de ses droits? Ce que vous menons, c'est une formalité qui a été effectuée.
I did indeed hear that, and then I heard the witness say that he was unclear.
Alors, je vous ai également indiqué à la pause que le témoin avait été informé aussi de ses droits par l'unité d'appui aux experts et aux témoins.
In December 2011, before the position of the prosecution was made plain, that's the point I've been trying to make. But perhaps I'm just doing a very bad job of making it. That's the point I'm trying to make, that this waiver, this notice, this briefing that is given to the witness needs to be comprehensive, needs to reflect the position.
Voulez-vous dire qu'il n'a pas été exhaustif ce matin? Voulez-vous critiquer la façon dont le président a averti le témoin de ses droits? Considérez-vous que c'est à vous de procéder à cet avertissement?
Well, with respect, Your Honor, that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm criticizing, I'm taking issue with, I'm not, it's not a personal attack, I'm criticizing the manner in which the briefing was given. I'm saying, we're saying, that it wasn't comprehensive, that it doesn't reflect all of the consequences for this witness. I'm not criticizing anyone personally.
Eh bien, je pense que la Chambre appréciera.
Thank you, Your Honor.
មេធាវីនៅមុខប្រគល់សិទ្ធជូននៅលោកស្រីទីស្រីណានៅក្នុងការលើកសំណួរជាមួយនឹងលោកស្រីអេលីសាបេតស៊ីមណូហ្វពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសាក់សីលោកនេះសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានបាទអរគុណច្រើនឥឡូវនឹងព័ត៌មានសំឡំមមហើយនឹងដោះស្រាយបានហើយលើបញ្ហាជំរងចម្រាស់នេះទៅកើតឡើងពីព្រឹកមិញនេះលើបញ្ហាការអនុវត្តនៅវិធានប្រភេទ 8 ចុច 8នេះសូមអញ្ជើញលោកមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិការពារក្តីលោកនួនជា
Thank you, Mr. President. I'll be very brief. I just want to announce that Nguyen Chia would like to follow the rest of the proceedings from the holding cell, and we have the waiver here for you to look at for the usual reasons. Thank you. មិនចូលរួមសម្មនាការដោយផ្ទាល់អង្គជំរះសម្រេចយល់ព្រមតាមដំណើរសុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាដែលបានស្នើសុំតាមរយៈមេធាវីការពារក្តីបកគាត់ស្នើសុំទៅតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្មនាការពីចម្ងាយពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្មនាការនេះដោយគាត់លះបង់សិទ្ធិមិនចូលរួមកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្មនាការដោយផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្មនាការនេះតែអង្គជំរះតម្រូវឲ្យក្រុមមេធាវីការពារក្តីលោកនួនជាផ្ដល់ឲ្យមកជំនុំជម្រះមកឲ្យអង្គជំរ
chuyên chụp chào khi sầm phón ở nằm cọt một căn vật tục sầm nà ca này vĩnh nơi được xuyên đi nơi màu môi sàn thập nhật ti đôi khi này cứ một trời rất ba tala cá sầm ở anh chơi mì tử vi nâng xã xây một căn vật tục sầm nà ca cái này bắt đầu từ khay cắm nơi được xuyên đi nơi màu môi sàn thập nhật ti sầm ra cho